everyone, welcome to another episode of Crypto Talk. So every session for Crypto Talk, we will introduce a special guest who will come onto our show and share a little bit more of their knowledge on the blockchain and the cryptocurrency industry. So this week, we are very honored to have Sridha, who is from Odds Finance, and he is the CTO and the co-founder. Welcome, Sridha, to our show.
Hey, hi, Jess. How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Yeah, I'm doing good. First of all, thanks for inviting me to this show. It's really a pleasure being here and sharing some information regarding whatever I gained from last few years.
Great. I think a lot of our viewers they may not have that much knowledge of the crypto industry. So maybe from yourself, from a professional background, what kind of topics do you think you will want to cover today to share with our audience?
Sure, I just want to talk a little bit more on options because, we at Odds Finance, we are actually building an options trading platform. And then along with other norms of the derivatives. So maybe, I'll briefly explain how options actually work for cryptocurrencies.
Sure.
As a step by step, right? So yeah, to begin with, let's imagine, all of us actually own some of the cryptocurrencies, right? We are all obviously investors at the end of the day. And, sometimes we feel insecure about the market, let's say, recently there was a correction, market correction, right? Sometimes, if we want to edge our positions, we tend to, there has to be some mechanism for hedging your positions, right? For example, let's say you own a Bitcoin worth of $50,000 and, you feel insecure about the market condition and you think that, okay, market may go down and you still want to sell your Bitcoin at the 50,000, right? So in such cases, what you can do, you can buy an option contract called put with the strike price being 50,000. And in such cases, if the strike price, if the Bitcoin current price goes below 50,000, you can still sell your option, a Bitcoin at 50,000. So this is the, a power of the option contract. So just because you paid some premium, imagine it as an insurance policy, right? Whenever you are buying a car, you also buy an option, insurance policy. So This is something more of a, options are more of a insurance when you think the market will go down. And similarly, let's say, you only have 5,000, you still want to buy a Bitcoin because you think Bitcoin will go above, 50,000 or 60,000 or maybe 100K by this end of this year, right? In such cases, what you can do with the limited capital that you have, as a first step, you can buy the Bitcoin option contract called call option. And let's say expiry being end of the year and the strike price being the current price, and sometime later this year the Bitcoin will go to 100K and you will still be able to buy the Bitcoin at a strike price that you selected. Let's say if the strike price was 50,000 and if the current price of the Bitcoin is 100K, you will still be able to buy the Bitcoin at 50K. So that's the power of call option. So I would like to, encourage users to, go use our platform. And, we have written a lot of educational content and videos for explaining options. Myself being an option trader for 2-3 years in the US market as well as, in the crypto market as well, being a trader and being an investor, it's very essential to know that there is something called options and it's very, very powerful tool, especially when the market is, too volatile.
I see. Okay, great. Oh, I think even for me, derivatives for cryptocurrency options, I think it's a new topic as well. So I think even our viewers will get a good understanding of it with your explanation. So if anyone wants to know more about what Sridha has said, we're going to link his link in the description box so you guys can go over to the website and have a look at it. Thank you so much for sharing once again. I think it's a really good educational sharing session.
Yeah, it's my pleasure.
Now, moving on, let's talk about your project, Odds Finance. What are the plans that you have for your project? Any future plans down the pipeline or anything interesting that you would like to share with our viewers on your project?
Sure. So recently, on 7th of June 2021, we actually launched our testnet on BSE. I would like to share a little bit more about the metrics. you know, like that we collected recently. You know, like that, there has been a very tremendous interest to test out our application, and we got about 20k applications, out of which we had to shortlist around 10k, and there has been nearly 25k options created, and there has been nearly 1 million liquidity provided on the testnet using the facets we actually kind of given to the test users, all the eligible test users. And similarly, you know, like looking at the, at these metrics, there is a huge interest for options and derivatives trading platform. So that is the reason, you know, like as we said right from the beginning, Arts Finance was always wanted to become a multi-chain, you know, not limit ourselves to one blockchain, right? So we recently launched on BSC, and you know, soon we are launching on Polygon, and later on Ethereum, and then like on Polkadot, so and so, right? So that is one thing. And the other, on the other side, you know, options is just the beginning of Arts Finance. You know, like we also have perpetuals being built out, and then like there is also conditional tokens being built out from the Arts Finance company. And also, you know, like we also have, you know, like our smart contract protocol auditing is being going on, and soon we will have a mainnet launch as well. And after that, you know, like it's more around, you know, like improving the platform, and you know, like ensuring we always come up with the algorithms where all the, you know, like retail investors as well as the institutional investors will actually kind of get the maximum benefit from our platform.
I think it's very interesting to know about your projects or future plans. Thank you so much for sharing with us on your project. I think for viewers who are interested in your projects, they can, you know, always refer to the links, and they can always ask questions on this YouTube video, and maybe Sridhar can answer their questions as well.
Yeah, sure. We are glad to, you know, help out all the users coming onto our platform and want to test out our application. And you know, like this is just the beginning, right? Like testnet is always the beginning, and then later we'll have mainnet, and then like we'll have more and more product releases. And you know, like we are considering this as a typical company, you know, like this is not like build a project and, you know, build a protocol, let people use it for a few days and let the project die. You know, we are not that kind of people. We just want to build a longer company for the longer duration, and we keep on, you know, we would want to, you know, keep on build the products for longer duration. And you know, it's not just, you know, we are not just limiting ourselves to options. There are other you know, like norms in the derivatives, right? For example, you know, conditional tokens, etc., right? So we just want to make sure we are, you know, like Arts Finance is one, you know, like one place for all the, you know, derivatives. So technically, I would say, you know, like in the future, we are also thinking of building a swap interface of our own, and that would actually kind of make us, you know, like Robin Hood for cryptocurrencies, I would say, you know, when it comes to the, you know, decentralized exchanges, right? So yeah, that's one thing.
Yeah, a Robin Hood, like a one stop for all, right? Great. Oh, I really love your explanation about your project. You know, there's so much going on in there, and there's just so much plans that you are planning for the project. And also, I think we are all very looking forward to all your media shout outs and everything that you're going to be doing. I think it's just so interesting.
Thank you.
So moving on to our next segment, I believe we are doing a giveaway. Are we?
Yes, of course. Yeah, I mean, like we are actually giving away about $50 each for 3 users, and it's a pretty small question, simple question, I would say.
All right, let's hear it from you, the question.
Yeah, so the question is, what are the features that are live on Arts Testnet? So if they go to testnet.arts.finance and start using our testnet application, they would know all the features that we've actually kind of launched recently. And the options are staking, option trading platform, liquidity provision, and all of these. So these are the 4 options, and anybody who would answer the right, you know, like who would come up with the right answer, they would get, you know, three lucky winners will get $50 each.
Great. Yeah, I think for everyone who is watching this video now, if you have been paying attention to what Sridhar has been saying earlier, I think you'll be able to get the answers pretty easily. So once again, 3 winners will walk away with 50 USDT worth of odds tokens. So just leave a comment with the right answer in the comment box below, and we will choose 3 lucky winners to walk away with the tokens. Before we end off this session, do you have anything else you want to add, Sridhar? Anything to say to our users?
Yeah, I mean, like, so I just want to, you know, once again, specify that, you know, like, we recently launched our testnet and we got a tremendous interest, and we are also going live on, other blockchains as well. So based on your interest, based on your need, please do explore our trading platform and start using and give us the feedback. We are really happy to, you know, collect your feedback and work on the feedback and then, you know, improvise the trading platform.
Excellent. So for everyone who's interested in the project in Odds Finance, we are going to leave the links in the description box below. So all of you, feel free to hop onto the website, feel free to leave a comment or ask any questions at all. So with that, we are going to end today's session. Thank you so much, Shrida, for coming on to our show. And for anyone who's new here, do remember to like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. So we'll see you guys next week for another episode of Crypto Talk. Thank you. Bye-bye, Shrida.
Bye-bye. Thank you so much for having me here.